Dear students, welcome you all to the course that is Apparel Production Planning and Control, that is APPC. So, in the last sessions, we have discussed about what is exactly the marker and how we can calculate the marker efficiency. So, while preparing the marker, what are the points to be considered while preparing the marker? We have seen in the last session, and along with that we have seen that what are the different types of fabrics available and how we can prepare a marker and what are the checkpoints to be considered while preparing the marker for particular type of fabric. Like the fabric types are like the symmetrical patterns and asymmetrical patterns. So symmetrical patterns in the stripes and the weft stripes or cross stripes. So there are two types of stripes, like warp stripes and weft stripes, and that too in both the cases we have symmetric patterns and asymmetric patterns. And in the checks also we have symmetric patterns and asymmetric patterns. So by considering the type of fabric and how we have to make the marker, for particularly by considering the fabric type we are using particularly. So along with that, we have already discussed about how we can plan for the printed fabrics and how we can prepare a marker for the printed fabrics. So today's session, we are going to discuss about the spreading techniques. So we'll see first what is exactly the fabric spreading and what are the techniques involved or methods involved in the spreading, so specifically in the garment industry. Let us see the nature of fabric packages. So what is exactly the nature of fabric packages? So the fabric packages vary in length, width and makeup. So depends upon the requirement, depends upon the quantity of fabric. So what is the form of fabric package which is going to be received to the apparel industry is going to be different. So here there are different type of packages, we will see one by one, and the choice of packages to be delivered to a cutting room related to the characteristics of the fabric and the method of spreading employed. So the packages which we are receiving, the nature of the package or the form of package is directly depends upon the spreading technique or spreading method we have involved or we have in the industry. So depends upon the spreading type, we can ask the customer or we can ask the sourcing people to make the package in the specific form. So the form of the fabric piece that can be used as are follows. You can see here the woven fabric, that is rolled. So the fabric roll. So generally, like all woven fabrics are in woven width. So the package is at one, the fabric is at one layer, and the fabric is going to be wound onto a tube or cardboard which is having a diameter of like 7 to 8 centimeter. So that is depends, like, so approximately the diameter of that particular paper tube or cardboard core tube is having a dia of 7 to 8 centimeter. So on this tube we are going to wind the fabric, and the wounded fabric, that is fabric roll, is going to be sent to the apparel industry. So this is one of the best method or best package form for the particularly like a spreading machine. Like there are so many spreading type machines, like automatic spreading machines and manual spreading machines are there. So for particularly like a spreading machines, this type of form is very very useful. And the second case, that is a tubular fabric. So tubular fabrics or tubular knitted fabrics are one of the major thing. So these fabrics are comes generally in the tubular form, and that too in the flattened form, which is going to be rolled. So there are two different type of package forms. Like one is rolled form, it will come, along with that, sometimes the plaited form also comes. These fabrics are going to become. Okay, so like plaited, nothing but like a cardboard or a thick board, which is going to be like a rectangular shape, and on that particular paper or cardboard, this fabric is going to be wound. So the plaited fabric form is, it is. Okay, often the fabric width is required to fit the wearer body. Okay, the fabric fits the design. So the same thing like, so what is the exact nature of the package? So specifically like the fabrics, the knitted fabrics comes under the three categories. Like one is called as three categories, nothing but tubular fabric, which is going to be wound on the tube, that is I told specified cardboard tube, that is a core cardboard tube, and which is having the diameter of 7 to 8 centimeter, and the fabric which is a tubular fabric and it was flattened tubular fabric is going to be wound on the cardboard, that is rolled form. And the second form is like a tubular fabric only, and it is like a rectangular cardboard, and on the cardboard the fabric was wound in the tubular form. And the third case is like the knitting machines, and there are few separate or additional machines are available in the knitting production line, knitted fabric production line, so that are cutting machines. So after tubular fabric manufacturing, the fabric is going to be cut along with the fabric length. So there are cutters or there are scissors where the fabric is going to be cut so that the tubular fabric becomes a open width form. So this open width form of fabric is going to be wound on the roller form, or so majorly like a maximum cases this fabric is becoming available in the roller form. So these fabrics generally like after processing and after printing, the fabrics are going to be converted, or the fabric is going to be wound on the tube of a circular tube, that is paper circular tube. So in the rolled form it will come. So these are the two forms. One is called as a rolled form and the second one is called a plaited form. And the fabrics are like a rolled form with tubular fabric and rolled form with open width fabric. Okay. And plaited can be available in the both the cases. Okay. So that is a thing. What is exactly the rolled fabric roller of knitted fabrics and the plaited things are. So the next one is folded fabric, that is in the rolled form as well as the plaited form. Okay. So like as I mentioned earlier, there is a cardboard. So specifically like these kind of forms are available or following traditional fabrics like handloom fabrics and power loom fabrics, which are generally comes in the folded form. Okay. And sometimes like they'll use like a cardboard and they'll plate it on the cardboard, that is in the rectangular cardboard, the fabric is going to be plated or rolled onto the cardboard. So this is the traditional thing, traditional type of fabric package forms available. Okay. So generally this is used for the less ordered quantities and few. And more ordered quantities, like the fabric is having a length of like 500 meters or 1000 meters, in that case generally they'll prefer for the roll type of fabric package. Okay. So that is the thing. And the velvet hangings are one of the model. So more rarely some velvets may be delivered wound on the special constructed frames to prevent the pile becoming crushed. So pile fabric, velvet fabrics which are there generally. So this will follow a specific package type, like there is a special construction frames are there so that the fabric is going to be hang onto the fabric frames, and so that there should not be any damage to the piles of the fabric specifically. And there has been a trend towards heavy pieces like 500, even 1000 meters also. And these are the specific fabric package forms which we have. So for example, if we want, or if we want to use the fabric in the spreading department or in the cutting department in an apparel industry, so in that case specifically we have to see that what is the type of spreading machine is available with us. So if we have a automatic spreader, so what is the type of package is required, what is the input package to the spreading machine is required, has to be considered. So depends upon the type of spreading machine available with us, we need to ask the sourcing people, or we need to ask the weaving manufacturers, or the fabric which is delivering to us, we need to ask them to make in the same form which we have required in the spreading machine. Okay, so these are the nature of the fabric packages which are generally followed or used in the apparel industries. And coming to the next point, that is actual, what is exactly the spreading is. Okay, so the objective of spreading is mainly the main objective to place the number of plies of fabric. So nothing but spreading, nothing but there is a fabric that is in the roll form. So we need to open the fabric in the on the table. So we have a spreading table, like a lengthy table, so where we are going to spread the fabric on the table. So the fabric is going to be opened and spread on the table. So you can see here the objective I have mentioned here. The objective of spreading is to place the number of plies of fabric, to place the number of plies of fabric that the production planning process has specified to the length of the marker plan. So don't forget the marker. I have discussed in the previous session marker, what is the marker length. Okay. And as per the marker length required, color required, so these fabrics are going to be aligned correctly. So the width has to be taken care and the tension has to be taken care while the fabric is going to be spread on the spreading table layer by layer. Nothing but there is a one ply, then the same fabric is going to be having a second ply. So second fabric is going to be laid down on the first layer, then third layer, then fourth layer. Like that, there are number of plies which we are going to spread on the table, one above the other. So that what will happen, if a marker is having two different sizes, these two different sizes of particular garment components or patterns are going to be produced. Nothing but two garments are going to be produced in each ply. So if we have 100 number of plies, if one ply is producing two garment cut components or patterns, so 100 plies, nothing but 100 into 2, total 200 number of garments we are going to produce by 100 plies of the fabric. So the objective is, without any change in the tension, without any change in the width and length, so exact length of the fabric has to be spread layer by layer, and the width of the fabric has to be maintained, nothing but one above the second fabric lay has to be properly spread on the table. Then only, so if there is a displacement of the fabric, okay, then your cut components or your garment patterns are not going to come correctly. So that is why the major thing you have to see is, while spreading, you have to mention or you have to control all these points. So what is the marker length, what is the marker width? So as per the marker length and what as per the marker width, we have spreaded the fabric or not. And if you spread the first layer, second layer is matching to the first layer or not. Okay. So is there any tension or slackiness is there while spreading? You need to remove the slackiness, you need to remove the tension. So you have to relax the fabric plies in the spreading table. So this is the main objective of spreading equipment. So what are the different parts or different components we are using? So the first one is in the spreading department or in the cutting department, we have a spreading tip. So there is a standard. Here I have shown a standard 2 meter spreading table. So generally in the spinning in the apparel industries, so the fabric spreading length, the table length is too lengthy, like 20 meters of fabric spreading table length. So spreading table length becomes like a 20 meters or 10 meters. That is depends upon the marker and depends upon the style of the garments we are producing. So out of 20 meters, you can utilize 5 meter or even in the 10 meters also. No issue. So the spreading table is having a lengthy, but you are going to utilize not whole the length. You are going to utilize a part of the spreading table. So why? Because after spreading, whatever the plies, say for example 100 plies or 50 plies if you have made, so these 50 plies or 100 plies has to be relaxed for a particular time. So particular time, nothing but approximately 8 hours or 12 hours of time has to be relaxed, so that the fabric relaxation, nothing but fabric actual width and length will be going to come. So your after cutting, your cut components will not vary any dimensional changes in the cutting. So after cutting, okay. So that is why we are utilizing the table. So a part of the spreading table, okay. So this is the standard spreading table I have shown here. And so you can see here a 10 meter lay of shirting fabric with 200 plies can weight up to 600 kg. And with 150 centimeter width, fabric can be exported. Nothing but just I have given, if the fabric is having 200 plies and approximately this fabric weighing at 600 kg. So what is the requirement of the particular table is, table has to be very strengthy. So if you keep 1000 kgs of weight on the table also, the table has to do not be disturbed or to not break, okay. And so the downward pressure I have given here, the same thing. And the table may also bear the weight of a spreading machine. So even the spreading machine also going to be kept on the spreading table only, fixed on the spreading table only. And along with that, we are going to keep like a spreading table, spreading machine, as well as sometimes we are going to use the cutting machines also, okay. So while operating, while cutting, the operator has to move the cutting machine through the marker on the particular garments. So the fabric plies are going to be cut by using the cutting machine. So it has to be traveled, and along with that, the weight of that particular band knife cutter or cutters used in the garment industry, weighing has to be sustained. So that is why generally the whatever the spreading table construction is there, it is having like a stainless steel or stainless steel material stand and frames are there for the table. Okay. So and along with that, we have few things on the spreading table. So there are like a plastic laminate, and sometimes in this spreading table is having a small floating balls or small floating air floaters are there, so that the suction air is going to be created in the table. So why this suction air is created? For example, there is a table surface. If the surface of the table is smooth, then if you keep the fabric, and generally we are using like AC or some like air streams are running, so air drag forces are running. So the displacement of fabric ply on the table is going to be occur. So what we required is the fabric has to be firm with the table. Okay, firm with the table. So that is why what we have is, we have a small balls type of floating air balls are there. So what will happen, it will create the compressed air or suction air in the table, so that once the fabric is laid on the table, it will be going to compressed or sucked, so that firmly on the table the fabric is going to be laid. So the layer by layer we are going to keep all the things. So first thing is to assist or to get on the fabric on the table or fix the position on the table. And the second thing is to release the whatever the creases or sometimes like temporary creases are there, folds are there. So that once the suction air is there, so it will flatly it will be spread on the table. Okay. So without any creases or anything. So this enables heavy sections of lay to be moved easily along the surface of the table to cutting operation. Once again, to move the lays on the table also it is very becoming very easy if we have this such type of mechanism in the table. So that is why it has been given in the first point. So it is usually covered with a plastic laminate and tempered hardboard, which provides a low level of friction. But in more sophisticated examples, the table incorporates a source of compressed air, giving the facility of air floating through perforations in the table surface. Okay, so this is the main thing. Okay, and we'll move on to the methods of spreading. What are the methods? What is exactly the what are the methods we are going to follow in the spreading is? Okay, so let us move. So the methods of spreading is generally it is classified into two methods. One is by hand or manual method, and the second one is called as spreading using a traveling machine. So by hand we can spread the fabric, and the second one, by using a traveling machine, we are going to spread the fabric on the table. These are the two methods, by hand and the second one is traveling machine type. Okay, and we will see that first case, that is spreading by hand. So it is a time consuming method, usually required an operator at each side of the table. So if you have a table, so both the sides we required two operators. Okay, so these two operators are going to spread the fabric by manually on the spreading table. Okay, and the fabric is drawn from its package, which if the roll or fabric may be supported on the frame, the carried along the table where the end is secured by weights or clamps. So after fabric spread, so at one end of the fabric we have a secured dead weights or secured clamp, so that the fabric is going to be firmly holded by these mechanism. Okay, so this is the type of spreading by hand, and you can see here the typically the fabrics that are spread by hand are checks, crosswise stripes, other regular repeating patterns, as well as those with a repeating designs at intervals of a garment length. So if we have like these crosswise or checks, stripes, so these cases we are going to use by spreading by hand. So because we need to match the checks as well as the crosswise stripes, nothing but the weft-wise direction, weft stripes. So in that case, we need to match the stripes and checks. So specific cases we are going to use for the spreading by hand method. And the second one is called as that is spreading by traveling machine. Okay, spreading machines carry a piece of fabric from end to end of the spread. So nothing but there is a spreading machine. This machine is going to move or travel from one side of the spreading table to the other side of the spreading table. So this spreading machine or mechanism is going to hold on or handle the fabric roller, and the fabric is going to be released slowly onto the one above the other layer. So first ply will be done. After that the machine is comes back. If it is one way napping, so again it will be laid on the second layer, then again it will come back and third layer. So like that the machine is going to be traveled, or machine is going to spread the fabric on the spreading table. So this is like a very fast method. You can speed up the machine, speed of machine also you can increase if the gray kind of fabrics are available or mono color fabrics are available. So there is no checks or stripes, only plain fabric is there. So in that case, easy to prepare the or spreading the fabrics one layer by other. Okay. Then their basic element consisting of frame or carrier, wheels traveling, that I have already told. So there are guide rails at edge of the table, the fabric support and the guide collars to be aid correct unrolling of the fabric. So there are like a small driving mechanism for to the fabric roller, as well as the fabric traveling purpose also we have a fabric supporting belts or fabric supporting rollers are there. And after that it is going to be delivered slowly. The unrolling of the fabric is going to be done positively. So nothing but the package and everything is going to be rotated and fabric is going to open with the help of mechanism. Okay, there should not be any pull out or pulling of the fabric from the package is going to happen. Okay, so by mechanism itself it will pull and it will give the or spread on the table. Okay, so that is the thing. The maximum fabric width that can be handled is normally 2 meter. Okay, and although extra wide machines capable of handling up to 3 meters are available. So this is fabric width we are talking. So whatever the length is required, you can feed the length in the system itself. So it is like a microprocessing control unit or servo motor controlling units. So where you can program the, you can give the program what is the length and what is the speed, the parameters you can give in the particular spreading machine. Okay, and the maximum weight of the cloth roll that can be carried larger spreading machine is 120 kg. Okay, and with the speed of 100 meters per minute and maximum height of the spread cloth, that is up to 28 centimeters of height of the spread cloth can be there. Nothing but number of plies. So whatever the number of plies you are doing, so maximum is 28 centimeter. Okay, so this 28 centimeter, whatever the height is there, you can go up to that level of number of plies on the spreading table by using this spreading machine. Okay, and these are the few things. Like one of the major thing, like there is a paper, perforated paper sheet is going to be used at the bottom of the fabric plies. So before spreading the fabric on the spreading table, we are going to spread the the perforated fabric or perforated cloth sheet, so or perforated paper sheet. So this paper is going to be spread first, then after this, above the paper, we are going to spread the fabrics, so that whenever we required to transport or to move the fabric plies, all the fabric plies, you can hold the paper along with the fabric plies and you can easily move from one place to other place on the spreading tables. So that is a major purpose to use this cloth or to use the paper board. And you can see here the one of the equipment, the spreading machine I have shown here. So this is like a computer connector or controlled panel system. So completely automatic spreading machine. And here also I have given one of the example or how the fabric is going to be spread one above the other layer by layer. Okay, and we will move on to the next part, that is spreading methods or spreading mode. Okay, so the last we have discussed about what is exactly the package forms or nature of fabric forms, and we have discussed about what is exactly the spreading is, and we have seen that what are the spreading equipments available. So by hand method and by automatic methods, what are the spreading equipments are available, and now we will see what are the different modes of spreading, different modes of spreading or different ways of fabric spreading on the spreading tables. Okay, so there are basically 4 different types of spreading modes. One is called as nap one way and face one way. Nap one way, face one way. The second one is called as nap either way, face to face. Nap either way, face to face. I will tell you, napping nothing but spreading the fabric. Napping nothing but one nap, one spread. So nap one way nothing but only from one side we are napping, we are spreading the fabric from only one side, nothing but, say for example, there is an automatic spreading machine. The spreading machine is going to start spreading the fabric on the spreading table from this side to this side. Then again, fabric roller and spreading table, everything, spreading machine, everything, it will come into the same position. Then again, it will be spread. So I'll discuss one by one. So in the further slides. And third one is nap one way, face to face. Nap one way, face to face. And nap either way, face on face. So these are the four different types of spreading modes. We will discuss one by one. So the first one is called as nap one way, face one way. Nap one way, face one way. What is exactly the nap one way and face one way is? So this is the most common spreading method that can also be done manually. Okay, nap one way. From one side to the other side, the fabric is going to be spread. And you can see that generally the fabric roll is kept on a roller stand and the fabric end is being pulled by the two spreading operators walking along both the sides of the cutting table. So nothing but there is a fabric roll, say for example, this is the fabric roller width, okay, and this fabric roller width, that side 1%, this side 1%. So both the sides of the cutting table or spreading table, we have two workers, and there is a spreading equipment or spreading mechanism where the fabric roller is fixed. Now what we are doing is manual spreading. Both the persons are going to hold the edge of the fabric and pulled on the spreading table. So that is a one thing. Now we will see here what is exactly this nap one way, face one way is. You can see there are four fabric plies. So that one particular line where we have shown the grids or lines. So these particular lines, you can observe that. So the direction of fabric, the direction of fabric. So there is a fabric, and if you observe that there are lines, so these lines are indicates that this is the face side of the fabric. This is the face side of the fabric. And the fabric is going to be spread from one side to the other side. So you can see here, the arrow indicates the fabric is going to start from this side and it will end. And again, there is an arrow, second arrow I have shown, the fabric spreading equipment is come back to its original position. And then second spread is going to be occur. Then after completing the spread length, then again the spreading machine will come back to its original position. Then third ply. Then again coming back. Then fourth ply. And you need to observe that all the fabric plies, the face side of the fabric is at top side. So you can see that napping is going to be done at one side, only one side, and the fabric face side will be only one side. So that is why it is called as nap one way, face one way. Nap one way, face one way. Don't confuse. Napping one side, face of the fabric is only one side. So this is the one case. Okay. And we will see into the second one. So the same explanation I have given here. Okay. And the second one is called as nap either way, face on face. Nap either way, face on face. You can see that here I have shown, you can observe that the lines which are showing cross lines above the horizontal line, that indicates the face side of the fabric. And you can observe that first ply to the second ply, face side of the fabric becomes changed. So nothing but you can observe here what is the nap either way. Nap either way, nothing but say for example this spreading table is this side. Now it was moved and it was spread on the one ply, and you can observe here the arrow indicates again the spreading will be done on the second side also. Nothing but it is gone there. Again spreading is not breaked. It is not empty, it is not coming. So it is coming while folding, while again spreading. So nap either way, nothing but napping or spreading of the fabric from both sides. So first ply is at the right side and the second ply will be on the left side. And while it is moving, what will happen? If the fabric is folded, so I'll show you a small example. You can observe this. This is a, assume it is a fabric. It is a fabric. Now what is happening is, like you are folding the fabric, you are spreading the fabric. Now the spreading machine is started from this side, spread occurred, then the spreading machine is again spreading from the second side. You can observe that the fold is occurred. Now the fabric becomes twofold. So these two folds, what is the face side of the fabric for the bottom ply and the top ply? So the inside, whatever it is there, is the face side of the fabric. So this is the face side and this is the face side. So both together it was done like this. Okay, so the similar case I have told here, I have explained here, the fabric is going to be plied from both the sides. One side it is got, the second side, second ply. Third, again the first ply. Fourth, again. So you can observe that I have shown here the fabric is going to be plied like this. The spreading can be occur like this. Okay. So this is, that is why it is called as nap either way, face on face. So the both the fabrics are having face on face. Okay, face on face. So that is the thing. So this is the quickest spreading method because there is no time lapse. In the first case, you can observe that first ply has occurred. Then again, the machine has to come back its original position. Then the second ply is started. So wastage of one movement is happening in the first place, first case. And the second case, it is not like that. Continuously, the fabric is going to be folded. And fabric is one layer by other. But what is the major thing is, the fabrics are going to be plied or going to be laid face to face. Okay, face to face. So not face one way. So it is face to face. Face to face, both the fabrics are. Okay. And the third one is nap one way. Nap one way, face on face. Nap one way, face on face. You can observe that napping can be occurred from only one side, but face on face. So what is the requirement we have? So after one nap, the spreading machine has to come back to its original position, and spreading machine has to rotate. Then spreading can be done. Then again it comes back to its original position. Then again spreading table has to rotate. So after rotation, only then it is possible to make such kind of spreading, that is face on face, nap one way. And fourth one is, so that is why I explained here that layer end of the fabric is being cut. Turn the table, rotate the fabric roll by 180 degrees and return back to starting position without spreading. Okay. So that is the thing I have explained. So one ply has done, rotation can be done, come back to its original position, then second spread. So this is the way, this is how the third case is going to be done. And you can see the fourth one, that is the last spreading method or spreading mode, nap either way, face one way. Nap either way, face one way. Nap either way, again you need to think about. Nap either way means both the, from both the sides napping can be done. So fabric is started from this side, end up to this side, then again the starting at end to the starting side again. Okay, this is how the napping can be done. But what is the main thing is you need to rotate the fabric roller. So after the completion of the dead end, the fabric roller has to rotate. Okay, then napping can be done. Okay, then only you can achieve face one way. Then only you can achieve face one way. Otherwise, you will not achieve face one way. You will achieve, if you are not rotate the fabric roller, you will achieve only face to face. Face to face, that is second method. Okay. So these are the different spreading methods or modes we are using in the spreading machine in the cutting department. Okay. So this is all about the spreading and spreading equipments and spreading modes are okay. So the final one I have explained. Okay. And you can see here different spreading modes and different spreading parameters. So you can see that the column one says spreading parameters and the columns are showing that different spreading modes. Nap one way, face one way. Nap either way, face on face. Nap one way, face on face. Nap either way, face one way. So you can see that the spreading parameters, what is possible, what is not possible, what are the requirements, how we can use the parameters, what are the parameters are there for spreading is I have shown here. So manual spreading, it is possible in case of nap one way, face one way, and it is difficult in nap either way, face on face, and it is impossible in the last two cases. So merchandiser spreading is possible in all cases. Dead heading is possible in nap one way cases. Nap either way cases it is not possible. Turntable is not required in the first two cases, but in the last two cases it is required. That is, I told you, the turning table at 180 degrees revolution or rotation is required in two cases. So that is nap either way face on way and nap one way face on face. And these are the few things you can go through this. And this is all about the spreading and spreading modes and what are the different machines or equipments we are using in the while spreading, I have explained. And this is all about. So we'll discuss in the next session about the few things related to the biased grains and step lay and splicing. Till then, thanks for listening. Bye.